One.
When I was a child, my mother gave me a clock. She said, "This was your father's, a symbol of his luck, to always hold it with me, be precious with his time, as long as I would hold him, forever. So I began to count the ticking without chime, the hands that went in circles, cascaded through my mind. Minutes unused were pardoned, wasted hours were a crime. Each day by its dictation, his disappointment redefined. Sometimes, when I was dreaming, I'd see his distant line, a star with no circumference, yet fierce, blazing, bright. Then, one day, I stopped counting, but the ticking didn't stop. Hands that kept on falling would rise and rise and rise as time began to wither. So did wasted eyes. I saw what I'd been keeping out, the freedom deep inside. Now long ago, and slowly I learned with time, my father's clock that I'd kept counting had actually